Hello friends, here is the video for Marine Engineering Interview Questions Part 1. Now we'll discuss the questions in the personal interview. The first question will be, tell me about yourself. So the answer pattern to this will be as follows. First, you will tell your name. The second, you will tell your education background, then the family background, and at last, the hobbies. The second question will be, what are your strengths and weaknesses? The third and the most important question will be, why do you choose Merchant Navy? You need to give a strong response to this question. And the last question will be, why should we hire you? So friends, let us now discuss some technical questions that can be asked in the interview. So the questions are as follows. The first question is, define engine and types of engine. Your answer should be up to the point. So let us now discuss the answer. Engine is a mechanical device used to convert chemical energy into mechanical energy. There are two types of engine. Internal combustion engine. In the internal combustion engine, the combustion of fuel takes place inside the engine. Two-stroke and four-stroke petrol and diesel engine are the examples of internal combustion engine. The second one is the external combustion engine. In external combustion engine, the combustion of fuel takes place outside the engine. Examples of external combustion engine is steam engine. After that question, interviewer may ask you the different types of internal combustion engine. There are different types of internal combustion engine and their classification depends upon various bases. The first is the types of design. They are of two types. Reciprocating engine. In reciprocating engine, there is a piston and a cylinder. The piston does reciprocating, that is to and fro motion within the cylinder. Due to the reciprocating motion of the piston, it is called reciprocating engine. For example, two-stroke and four-stroke engine. The second is the rotary engine. In rotary engine, the rotor does rotary motion to produce power. There is no reciprocating motion. A rotor is present in the chamber which does rotary motion inside a chamber. Wankel rotary engine, turbine engines are the rotary types of engine. Second one are on the basis of types of fuel used. On the basis of types of fuel used, the engine is classified as petrol engine, diesel engine, and gas engine. Petrol engine. The engine which uses petrol for its working is called petrol engine. Diesel engine. The engine which uses diesel for its working is called diesel engine. Gas engine. An engine using gas fuel for the working is called gas engine. The third one is on the basis of cycle of operation. On the basis of cycle of operation, the engine types are Otto cycle engine. These types of engine work on Otto cycle. Diesel cycle engine. The engine working on diesel cycle is called diesel cycle engine. Dual cycle or semi-diesel cycle engine. The engine that works on both diesel as well as Otto cycle is called dual cycle engine or semi-diesel cycle engine. The diagram for Otto cycle engine, diesel cycle engine and dual cycle engine are given on the right side for your convenience. The fourth one is on the basis of number of strokes. Four-stroke engine. It is an engine in which the piston moves four times, that is two upward from BDC to TDC and two downward from TDC to BDC. Movement in one cycle of power stroke is called four-stroke engines. Two-stroke engine. The engine in which the piston does two times motion, that is one from TDC to BDC and other from BDC to TDC to produce a power stroke is called two-stroke engines. Now the interviewer can ask you, what is buoyancy? Buoyancy, also known as the buoyant force, is the force exerted on an object that is wholly or partially immersed in a fluid. Now, the next question is, what is viscosity? It is defined as the resistance to the flow of the fluid offered by its internal layers due to internal frictions. It is measured in centistokes. The next question is, what is resistance? Resistance is the opposition that a substance offers to the flow of electric current. Resistance is measured in ohm. The next question is, what is crankshaft and types of crankshaft? Crankshaft is the backbone of diesel engines and transmits power from the cylinders to the propeller shaft. Types of crankshafts. Crankshafts are of three types. One-piece construction. Either cast or forged is usually restricted to the smaller medium and high-speed engines. After casting or forging, operation crankshaft is machined and oil passages are drilled. The second is the built-up crankshaft. It is further divided into two subtypes. The first one is fully built-up. Webs are shrunk onto journals and crankpins. The second subtype is the semi-built-up. Webs and crankpins as one unit shrunk onto journals. The third type of crankshaft is welded construction. It has steel cast units comprising web, half crankpin and half journal pin. These are welded together at journals and crankpins to form one complete crankshaft. The next question is, what is freshwater generator and the principle behind its working? A machine used on board for conversion of seawater into freshwater by vacuum distillation based on evaporation and condensation. Basic principle of all low pressure freshwater generator is that boiling point of water can be reduced by reducing the pressure of the atmosphere surrounding it. By maintaining a low pressure, water can be boiled at low temperatures, say 50 degrees Celsius. The source of heat for the freshwater generator could be waste heat rejected by main engine jacket cooling water. The next question is, what are the various methods to generate freshwater on board? Boiling evaporator, freshwater generator, flash evaporator, freshwater generator, and the reverse osmosis plant. Let us now move to the next question. What is MARPOL and what are the annexes of MARPOL? MARPOL is the main international convention aimed at the prevention of pollution from ships caused by operational or accidental causes. It was adopted at the International Maritime Organization in 1973. There are six annexes. Annex 1. Regulation for the prevention of pollution by oil. Annex 2. Regulation for the control of pollution by noxious liquid substances. Annex 3. Regulation for the prevention of pollution by harmful substances carried by sea in packaged form. Annex 4. Regulation for the prevention of pollution by sewage from ships. Annex 5. Regulation for the prevention of pollution by garbage from ships. Annex 6. Regulation for the prevention of air pollution from ships. The next question is, what is special area? Special areas are defined as certain areas in which, for technical reasons relating to their oceanographical and ecological condition and to their sea traffic, the adoption of special mandatory methods for the prevention of sea pollution is required. Under the convention, these special areas are provided with a higher level of protection than other areas of the sea. Special areas in MARPOL 7378 are the Mediterranean Sea Area, the Baltic Sea Area, the Black Sea Area, the Red Sea Area, the Gulf Area, the Gulf of Aden Area, the Antarctic Area, the Northwest European Waters, Oman Area of Arabian Sea, Southern South African Water. Thank you friends for watching my channel. Please like, share and subscribe my channel, and good luck for your interview.